Hello and all, welcome to our next class. Today we are discussing about Newton's second law of motion. Previous class we are discussed about what is Newton's first law of motion. And we are discussed that the first law is if a body is continue its state of rest or uniform motion until an external unbalanced force is acting on it. So that is Newton's first law of motion. And in first law of motion, a body is changing its position from rest to a position of moving or motion. Only an external unbalanced force is applied on that rest object. So here is a body in rest that is changing its position when a force is getting on it. So here is a phenomenon that is inertia. Inertia is that a body is in a state of rest or in a state of motion. An external unbalanced force is applied on it. The inability of a body that remains in that position is called inertia. That is, a body is changing its position when a force is applying on it. It is unable to not changing its state of rest. Because inertia is here, that's why a body is changing its position. It is unable to remain its original state when an external unbalanced force is getting on it. So, the first law is experiencing here that a force is applying on a body that is in a state of rest or a state of uniform motion. It changes its position when an external unbalanced force is applying on it. So, this is a body is unable to remain in that same position, and that is called inertia. And we have to retrospect what is the definition of inertia. Inertia, it is the inability of a body to change its state of rest or of uniform motion along a straight line by itself. That is, a body is unable to change its state of rest or state of uniform motion along a straight line by itself. That is called inertia. And there are two types of inertia. First one is inertia of rest and inertia of motion. And what is inertia of rest? That is, it is the tendency of a body to remain in its state of rest or its inability to change its state of rest by itself. That is called inertia of rest. Okay. That is, here are two types of inertia, that are inertia of rest and inertia of motion. Inertia are two types, inertia of rest and inertia of motion. A body is in a state of rest, an external unbalanced force is acting on it. It tends to change it or it changes its position. But in inertia, the body is unable to changing that position. The body having thing to remain that position, but inertia is here, that's why the body changes its position. And a body is in rest, the inability of changing its state is called inertia of rest. But a body is in motion, the inability of changing its position is called inertia of motion. So, there are two types of inertia, that is inertia of rest and inertia of motion. Inertia of rest is the inertia that is a body in rest. And inertia of motion, that is a body in motion. Okay, that is inertia is that the inability of remain its original state when an external unbalanced force is acting on a body. That body is in rest, that is inertia of rest, and that body is in motion, that is inertia of motion. Okay, and there are so many examples in our daily life that see inertia of rest and inertia of motion. In a passenger in a bus moving forward, when a bus is in rest state to the starting state, when a bus is starting, a passenger is sitting inside a bus is go to forward, that is the inertia of rest. That is, the passenger is in rest, changes his position, that is the passenger is moving. A movement of forward movement is here, but the passenger is not able to remain in rest state because an external force is here that is starting the bus. So the motion is occur, the passenger is moving forward, and the passenger is unable to remain in its original state of rest because inertia is here. That is the inability of that rest position, and that is called the inertia of rest. An athlete is running to track and he doesn't stop his running at a specified moment. That is, he is running some forward when he is stopping his running. And an athlete, he is take a run before when he jumping some side. These two are the examples of inertia of motion. That is, when a moving body is does not comes to rest in a specified time. This needs some more time to engine that motion, because inertia of motion is making that, inertia of motion is that a moving body is unable to stating or remaining its original state, that is in motion when an external force is getting to it. So in these two cases we can see that inertia of motion and inertia of rest is experiencing. So inertia is the inability of a body that remain in original state, and inertia of rest is the inertia that is basing a body is in rest, and a moving body having inertia, and that inertia is called inertia of motion. And the inertia is the term that is related to the Newton's first law of motion. Okay, and I think all of you understand about what is inertia and the two types of inertia. And there is a factor of an object that is relating the inertia of an object, that is mass of an object. The mass of an object and the inertia of that object is related to each other. How they related? Mass of an object and inertia of an object. Inertia of the object is the inability to remain its original state, and mass of the object is how they are related to each other. Mass of the object is increasing, inertia of the body is increasing. A higher mass body having higher range of inertia. That is, there is a example in our textbook that showing that a pod with tar is rolling and an empty jar is rolling. These two are rolling, but there is a slow rolling in higher massed container and slow speed movement in the lower massed or empty container. That is, the mass of the object is, or the mass of the body is increasing, the inertia is increasing. That's why there is a trouble to moving a higher massed object. That is the relation between inertia and mass of an object. Mass of an object is increasing, inertia of the body is increasing. So inertia is are of two types, that are inertia of motion and inertia of rest. And the mass of the body is related with inertia. The mass is higher, inertia is higher. Mass is increasing, inertia of the body is increasing. And there is another factor that is depending the motion of a body, and that is momentum. What is the momentum of an object? Inertia is one of the factor that depending a moving body, and that moving body having different properties, that are velocity, acceleration, and etc. And there is another phenomena that is connecting with a moving body, and that is momentum. What is the momentum of an object? If there are two balls, one is higher mass and one is lower mass, is putting on a tray that containing some sand, and these two balls making some two peaks, and one is a higher peak and the other one is a small peak, and this connecting, what is the momentum and what are the factors that is showing in the momentum? In momentum, the two factors are the mass of the object and the velocity of the object. The product of the mass of the object and the velocity of the object is called the momentum. That is a moving body having a position changing. That is a moving body having a velocity changing from initial velocity to final velocity. And a moving body having always mass. So the product of the velocity and the mass of the body is called momentum. Mass of the body is taken as m, and changing velocity is v minus u. So the product of mass and velocity is called momentum. So next we have to discuss in through slide what is the definition of momentum. It is momentum. It is a characteristic property of a moving object. It is measured as the product of the mass of the body and its velocity. Momentum equals mass into velocity and u. Okay, that is momentum is a characteristic property of a moving body, and it is the product of mass and velocity of the moving body, and the product of mass and velocity is called the momentum. And the unit of momentum is unit of mass into unit of velocity, that is meter, kilogram, meter per second. The unit of momentum is kilogram, meter per second. That is, the unit of mass is kilogram, the unit of velocity is meter per second, the unit of momentum is kilogram meter per second. So the momentum of a moving body, that is related with the mass of the body and the velocity of the body. When a body is moving, this having a change in velocity, that is the initial velocity from the final velocity. And every body having a mass, and the product of the mass and the velocity of that moving body is giving the momentum of that body. And momentum of the unit of momentum is kilogram meter per second. Okay, I think all of you understand what is the momentum of a body. And next we have to discuss what is Newton's second law of motion. In first law of motion, we are saying that an external unbalanced force is acting on the surface of a body that is in the state of rest or in the state of uniform motion. It changes its position. This is showing the Newton's second law of motion. There is an external unbalanced force is here, and the product of mass and acceleration is the external, which is equal to the external unbalanced force experiencing here. And this showing the Newton's second law of motion. The external unbalanced force acting on a body that is in the state of rest or uniform motion is equal to the product of mass and acceleration of a body is called the Newton's second law of motion. And from here we can write that F is the force here acting, and that is proportional to mass and velocity. M into V minus U divided by T. That is, F is proportional to M into V minus U by T. That is the acceleration. M is the mass of the body and V minus U by T is the acceleration of the body. The product of mass and acceleration is the external force, and which is proportional to M into V minus U by T. M is the mass of the object and V minus U by T is the acceleration of the object. And here we are using a proportionality constant, that is K. That is, F is equal to K M into V minus U by T. And here V minus U by T is equal to A, that is acceleration of a body. V minus U by T is the acceleration of the body, and we have taken that K into M A. And taken K is equal to 1, so F is equal to M A. The proportionality constant K is equal to 1, F is equal to M A. This is the equation for finding the force acting on an object that is in the state of rest or uniform motion. So Newton's second law of motion is giving the equation for finding the force experienced on a body. F is equal to ma. First of all, the force is proportional to or equal to the mass and acceleration of a moving body, and the acceleration of moving body is V minus U by T, that is changing velocity per time. V is the final velocity and U is the initial velocity. So the changing velocity is V minus U, and the acceleration is changing velocity per time. So acceleration is V minus U by T. So substituting V minus U by T into M, that is proportional to the force applied here. And using a proportionality constant K, and rewriting this equation, F is equal to this proportionality constant K makes the proportionality into equals. So F is equal to K into M into V minus U by T. And V minus U by T is equal to A, and applying this to equation. So F is equal to K into M into A. And K is taken as 1. The proportion, the value of the proportionality constant is taken as 1. And the force F is equal to MA. So F is equal to MA is the equation for finding out the external force applying on the surface of an object that is in a state of rest or state of uniform motion. So next we have to read what is the definition of Newton's second law of motion through slide. Newton's second law of motion. The rate of change of momentum of a body is directly proportional to the unbalanced external force acting on it. So mass into acceleration is the rate of change of momentum of a body is the external force acting on it, and this is the Newton's second law of motion. And the equation showing calculating force is F is equal to ma, and F is the force and m is the mass of the body and a is the acceleration of the body, and the product of acceleration of the body and mass of an object is the force that is acting on the surface of a body. Okay, and momentum of a body is the product of velocity, changing velocity and mass of an object, and changing velocity per time is called the acceleration. So the rate of change of momentum is proportional to the force applying on the surface of an object, and this is the Newton's second law of motion. So I think all of you understand about how the mass into acceleration product is comes to in terms of momentum, because the changing velocity is acceleration, changing velocity per time is acceleration, and rate of change of momentum is, so that is taken as A. So F is equal to ma is the equation that is showing the force applied on the surface of an object. So today we are discussing about what is inertia of a body. And there are two types of inertia, inertia of rest and inertia of motion. A body is in rest, the inertia experiencing that is inertia of rest. And a moving body having inertia, that is inertia of motion. Inertia is the inability to remain in original state or in state of rest or uniform motion of a body. And these two types of inertia are showing in different experiences in daily life. And next we are discussing about what is the Newton's second law of motion and how the momentum is related with Newton's second law of motion. Momentum is the characteristic property of a moving body, and it is the product of the changing velocity and mass of the body. And mass of the body and changing velocity. So the rate of change of momentum is proportional to the force applied on the body is showing the second law of motion. And this all over today's class.